Good day, guys. So today we're going to create realistic grass lawn. In this tutorial, we're going to be needing two things to do that. The first is our terrain. So this is our terrain. I've modeled it here in Sketchup, and you should always try as much as possible not to use a flat terrain when doing that. So you can see the terrain here. We have depression, elevation, just to give it that feel, that real life feel. Okay? And the second thing we're going to need is our grass middle. So here we have our grass middles. I actually got this from Globe. That's the grass model. And then I converted them to Sketchup boxes. Just to make Sketchup file lights. So the next thing we're going to do is to make sure that our ground, our terrain here has material. Just like in real life, terrain do have materials. So what I'm going to do is to apply a ground material, a default ground material that comes with Sketchup when installed. Now I'm going to use this. So this has been applied to our ground material, our ground terrain. Next thing we're going to do is to create the scatter geometry. What do I mean by scatter geometry? Come here, right click, scatter geometry. This scatter geometry is what we're going to use to apply this on this. That's to distribute these 5 boxes onto this terrain. Okay. Now, before doing that, we have to make sure that this has the scatter geometry. Now, how we're going to do this is this. Click on the terrain. I click on scatter, apply to selection. Once you do that, you're going to see this red bounding box. Before you actually do that, make sure that your terrain is a group. If it's not a group, you're not going to see this red bounding box. So make sure your terrain is a group before applying the scatter to it. Okay?
Yep.
The next thing we'll do is to distribute the geometries, this grass geometry. Distribute the grass geometry for our terrain, and the simple way of doing it is this. Click on each of the grass models, go to your scatter, click on add guest. The moment you do that, this will transfer to the add guests here. You can always click on this box, drag it down to see everything that has been added to the guest. The moment you do that, if you take a look at our terrain, you're going to see these little boxes distributed all over our terrain. These boxes are just our grass geometries. Okay, so let's test right now and see what we have. Let me end this. Save. So this is what we have right now, but we can add more instances, okay, depending on what you want to do, what you want to achieve. I really want a grass lawn that is full of beautiful grasses. Okay, so the way to do that is this. We have percentage view. All right, what this means is the number of instances you're going to see on your viewport, not what you render, okay, what you see on your viewport. So here on my viewport, I want to see 10% of everything that is happening. So I'm going to reduce it by 10. So if, assuming we have 100 boxes appearing here, when we render, they are going to be 1000. That's 100 times 10, that's 1000. Okay, now the next thing we'll have to discuss is the max count limit and the instance counts. Okay, max count limit is the limit of instances we'll see here. Above this number, nothing else is going to show. So now what I love to do is I make sure to increase this to 100,000 for a start. Now the instance count limit should not be higher than this. Okay, to be on the safer side, they should be equal. So let's start with 10,000 and see what our result is going to look like. You can see our instance is increasing. So let's test render at 10,000 and see. So this is what our graphs will look like at 10,000 instance counts. Let me stop it. Let's see. I think our count still increases. Let's take it to 100,000. And then let's render again and see. So this is at 100,000. Let's save and compare. A and D. This is 400,000 instance counts, and this is for 10,000 instance counts. We can see our graphs coming to life already. I think we can still add more just to cover up these patches. Okay. So the best thing for us to do is to increase our mask count limit to 200,000. And our instance count limit to 200,000. Let's test render and see. So let me stop it and let's compare. Save. So A is for 200,000 instance counts, while B is for 100,000. Instance count, I think 20,000 does the work for us. Okay. Now, having done that, the next thing we're going to do is to go to transform. Alright. Our objective here is to make it as real as possible. And to do that, we have to randomize a few things like rotation and scale. If you go outside to look at the grass outside, you notice that their blades are quite different from each other in terms of size, color, and rotation. So for the rotation on the z-axis, by default this comes from 0 to 360. Advice for you is to leave it the way it is. Okay, now the most important transformation we have to do is the scaling. So here our scale is 1:1. All right, that's they have equal scale. There's no much difference between each of our boxes here, our projects. Okay, so the scale from 1 to 0.8 and then 1.2. That's 0.8 of the original scale and 1.2 of the original scale. Let's test render and see. Just compare. So A is when our scale is from 0.8 to 1.2. That's this 0.8 to 1.2. And then this is from our former scale of 1:1. All right. I think we can still work more on the scale. Right. So let's try 0.8 to 1.1. And then let's test render again and see. I think this looks better, right? So the most important thing for you to know is this scaling. This is a very important tool to achieve that real life situation we see in nature. So just play around with this and then see what you can get. And once you are satisfied with your results, you can now move to the final settings. Okay, so this is just the way to create a realistic lawn in Sketchup for Vray. And we've come to the end of today's tutorial. But before we go, let's do our final render and see what our lawn is going to look like. So for our final render, I'll go to settings. Let's change the resolution. Let's go 4K. And then let's reduce our noise limits here. So let's click our final render. Here's the final image of our question. Okay, that's it for this tutorial. Thank you for watching and see you next time.